Chemtrails versus contrails. Climate engineering programs have been fully deployed for many years, just as genetically modified organisms have been put into our food supply. What if it appeared to be harmless, but it wasn't? What if you thought the persistent trails in the sky were strange or concerning, so you were called a conspiracy theorist because the mainstream media and, quote, 99%, unquote, of the expert scientists said you were a fool to be concerned? What is the difference between a chemtrail and a contrail, or condensation trail? In this example, courtesy of Hat's Truth, you can see aircraft flying to the upper right is leaving a wake of two plumes, one from each engine, that disperses fairly quickly. That is a typical contrail. The plume from the aircraft flying to the lower left is singular and persistent. Both aircraft are approximately the same size. Since one is flying eastward and the other is flying westward as they pass, they would have the required altitude separation of 1,000 feet of vertical airspace clearance. So they are in the same general atmospheric environment. What if the chemtrail conspiracy label is a cover story to keep your attention away from the topic of geoengineering? Will you stick with the consensus view, or make a choice to dig deeper? There are links in the box below the video for those who no longer trust the tyrants who say everything is safe and effective.